I like to quickly run to the third scripture. You know, the Lord spoke to me about it recently. Matthew chapter 15 is a scripture He has given me for many years, starting from November 2018, when the Lord said He talked to me first about the final reformation. However, recently He spoke to me saying, all men are rebels. He took me right back to the scripture. I'll read it to you very quickly from Matthew 15, verse 1 to 9. Then came to Jesus scribes and Pharisees, which were of Jerusalem, saying, why do thy disciples transgress the tradition of the elders? For they wash not their hands when they eat bread. But He answered and said unto them, why do ye also transgress the commandment of God by your tradition? For God commanded, saying, honor thy father and mother, and he that curseth father and mother, let him die the debt. But ye say, what whosoever shall say to his father and his mother, it is a gift, by whatsoever thou mightest be profited by me, and honor not his father or his mother, he shall be free. Thus have ye made the commandment of God of none effect by your tradition. Ye hypocrites, well did Isaiah prophesy of you, saying, these people draw now to me with their mouth, and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. But in vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men. You see, these two verses, he actually drives me to tears all the time. Verse 6 and 9 says, you have made the commandment of God non-effect. You have made the commandment of God of non-effect by your tradition. But in vain they do worship me, verse 9 says, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men. I don't want this episode to be so long, so I'll just quickly connect to the fourth scripture before I just put in one or two words and then wrap up. Colossians chapter 2, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. One of the major wars we have to fight from this platform will be the traditions of the elders, the traditions of men, the rudiments of this world, and not after Christ. This is one of the biggest things we have to rise up against. But I tell you, when He spoke to me that day, saying, all men are rebel, you know, everyone who is a reformer, I say this all the time, you must be called a rebel or a leader of rebels. Jesus was called the leader of rebels. You are training rebels. I mean, the purest Son of God, the best God has ever had, the greatest among mortals, the greatest among the holy. He was looked at as a rebel by the religious people of his day. If you have never been called this, then you are not a reformer. You can't be a reformer and not be called a rebel, because you have to be standing up against something. You have to be going against the norm. But you see, when God spoke to me that day, I realized that all men are rebels. And instead of a reformer trying to explain that he's not a rebel, just understand this. You're either rebelling against God, against His commandments, or you're rebelling against the traditions of men, and the traditions of the elders, and the rudiments of the world. The world will look at you and call you a rebel when you rebel against its rudiments. People will look at you and call you a rebel when you rebel against the things that they stand for. But you see, with all my heart, I currently, lovingly, I'm rebelling against whatsoever makes the bride take her eyes away from the groom. I'm rebelling against whatsoever makes men leave God and follow others. I'm rebelling against whatsoever makes men leave the commandments of God to follow the traditions of men or of the elders, whatever you choose to call it. With all my heart, I rebel against whatsoever stops the church from being raptured. I rebel against, with all my heart, whatsoever makes the last move of the Spirit seem to drag. Choose this day which group of the rebels you want to be in. The group that rebels against the commandments of God, or they who rebel against the traditions of the elders. There's nothing we can do about it. The divine line is now being drawn in the church. You can't be in the middle. You are either going to rebel against God or rebel against men. Choose where you want to be. You may never be called a rebel the way a reformer would definitely be called. It doesn't mean you are not a rebel. You have to be, you are always, you must be rebelling against something, because you are either lying up to God or to the traditions of men. I'll leave you here and see you again in the next episode of the Final Reformation.